House, Wantra Market, Clock Tower. What will come to your mind when you see these pictures? The development of old buildings in Hong Kong is really a controversial topic nowadays. It seems very difficult to balance the economic development and preservation of old buildings in Hong Kong. And many people have different points of views about this topic. In this documentary, we will visit Wantra Market, Clock Tower, Murray House, and Kum Tong Hall. Let us use the development of these buildings as reference and think again the relationship between economic development and conservation of old buildings in Hong Kong. Murray House is a Victorian-era building in Sanning in Hong Kong. Hong Kong Maritime Museum is located on the ground floor. There are some restaurants in the second floor. It is a popular tourist site. Built in 1844, Murray House was initially used as military camp by British military. During the Japanese occupation in Hong Kong, the building was used as the command center by the Japanese military police. In 1980s, Hong Kong transformed it from light industrial center into a trading center. Central became the central business center. Many skyscrapers were built there. In 1982, the Murray House was replaced by the new Bank of China Tower. Over 3,000 building blocks were labeled and cataloged for future restoration. The building was restored in 1998 and reopened in 1999.
In Central, there is an old building called the Kum Tong Hall, which has been built for almost 100 years. It was built in 1914 and it was the house of the affluent Ho Kum Tong family at first. This building is built in the classical style architecture of the Edwardian period, and it is decorated with stained glass windows, teak wood staircase, and panels. So, where is the fate of this old building now? Has it been demolished or preserved? In October 2002, the owner of the Kum Tong Hall, the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, submitted an application to the building authority to demolish this building. The government soon contacted with the church and they finally reached a consensus in preserving this building. Moreover, the government converted the Kum Tong Hall into Dr. Sun Yat-sen Museum, which introduced Dr. Sun's life and his revolutionary activities in Hong Kong. Besides, most of the old style and decorations of the buildings were still being kept after the museum had been constructed. So, apart from preserving the building, the Kum Tong Hall can also help the economic development in Hong Kong through the profits of the museum. It's really a win-win situation.
Wantra Market, where it was built in 1957, is located at 264 Queen's Road East Wantra in Hong Kong. It is in the architectural style in 1950s, such as streamlined modern. It is a great historic building. Wantra Market has been built for 70 years. It is very valuable and precious. So, we should protect this building. If this building disappears, we will lose our authentic building. And this is our loss. However, if this building continues to exist, younger can learn more about old buildings. Therefore, protecting Wantra Market is very important.
Economic development is very important in Hong Kong. The reason is that the population density in Hong Kong is very high. 7 million people are living in a place which is just about 1,104 km². As land price is increasing, areas around some old buildings have turned into skyscrapers that are used for commercial purposes in order to earn more profits. As a result, some of the old buildings must be demolished and replaced by the new infrastructures in order to help the economic development. However, the conservation of the old buildings is important in Hong Kong too. The main reason is that those old buildings are the public memory of people in Hong Kong. They can also help the development of tourism and education. Both economic development and conservation of old buildings are important to a city. So, let's think again some ways to strike the balance between them.